my great pleasure to invite to the stage a man who's been dubbed the father of multiculturalism in Australia. Himself an immigrant, he arrived here wearing someone else's shoes, the inspiration and the title for his book published last year. In Someone Else's Shoes has become a multicultural manual for students, politicians and business people right throughout Australia. Would you please welcome my friend, the founder of these awards, and always a major sponsor, a great believer in the harmony of diversity, the remarkable Mr. Joseph Assaf.
Thank you, Tracy. It has taken 22 years for these shoes to travel west with the awards. But finally, here we are. So, Premier Colin Barnett, Your Excellencies, heads of the various diplomatic missions represented here tonight, honorable ministers, senators, members, esteemed judges, valued sponsors, members of the media, guests, and of course, our finalists tonight. It is my great pleasure to be here this evening in Perth, welcoming you all to the 22nd Business Award Presentation Dinner. I'd like to thank Harry Sidus and the Doric Group for the initial invitation to come to Western Australia. And of course, Premier Colin Barnett and the Western Australian State Government for sponsoring and supporting this event. I'd also like to thank the Virgin Blue Group of Airlines, the first nationally based airline to get behind the awards. They have extended fantastic support at every level. A special thanks and welcome as well to Woodside, the newest member of our family of sponsors. Most particularly, though, I want to thank Australia's largest business banking group, the National Australia Bank, for their continued support. If you take a look at your invitations or the table booklets or the banners, then you will see that we are now officially founding partners. In fact, we have always been a partnership. The NAB has been there from the outset, and in redefining their sponsorship status, you might say we have renewed our vows. People sometimes do that kind of thing after 22 years if they are in a solid, a positive relationship. With the NAB, that has certainly been the case. We have gone from strength to strength. These awards celebrate and promote diversity because without diversity, there can be no harmony. Diversity is the coordination of differences, and a lack of diverse differences brings only monotony, which in the end spells death for any endeavor, artistic, cultural, or business. Ultimately, it can only be disastrous for any nation. In Australia, thanks heavens, diversity is a fact of life, and this fact of life should be all-inclusive. For the awards symphony to be complete, we needed to include the culture of the earliest migrants, the custodians of this land. The introduction of the Indigenous business category adds sounds and harmonies that resonate back through thousands of years to the very heart of the place that has welcomed and nurtured us new Australians. Already, this new instrument is being heard. As with the other players, the Indigenous Business Awards create role models. When you meet the finalists in this category tonight, you will see business people who have created wonderful paths for their own people, jobs that have been proudly generated, independent of any government support. They have written their own score. When the Asian financial crisis hit in the late 90s, Australia was not seriously affected. People were surprised. When more recently the global financial crisis hit, we were again not seriously affected. People were surprised. I wasn't surprised in either case. You want to know why? I wasn't surprised because I know that the contributions made by our diverse immigrant communities will always be a shot in the arm that will help to immunize our nation against the effects of such financial schisms. I wasn't surprised because I know that diversity of culture generates diversity of opportunity. I wasn't surprised because I know that our yearly stimulus of hundreds of thousands of migrants is a genuine safeguard against financial disaster. It is a safeguard because in effectively coordinating and using our differences, we can create a huge range of economic and market opportunities, both internally and internationally. Those hundreds of thousands of immigrants need thousands of homes. They need education. They need consumer products and services. Every one of them, in their own way, is a mini stimulus package. Those migrants also bring the ability to work, to build, to generate jobs, and to create huge export opportunities with their countries of origin through international business networks and through their own drive and energy. Look at our finalists tonight, the diversity of their origins, the different categories under which they came here, family reunion, skilled migrants, business migrants, refugees. Look at the diversity of their businesses, each calling on their own particular heritage, wine, food, clothes, bricks, paper. They build businesses which change not only their lives, but our lives as well. Productive diversity. It is one of the greatest stories to be told about Australia. It is one of the keys to our success. I fervently believe that we need to continue to build on that success with a well-studied and controlled immigration program that is in itself diverse. A program which embraces a wide variety of skills, cultures, races, and creeds. Yes, of course, we need a gatekeeper. But we need a gatekeeper who clearly understands that potential, not just of those who are already skilled or successful, but also of those who carry with them an empty suitcase. In an empty suitcase, there is room for dreams and creativity and resilience and a drive, all of the things that have brought our finalists here tonight. I congratulate them and I thank them. They are all winners, and so is Australia. Thank you.